Time in Glasgow. It's been so much fun.
It has become our favorite city so far on this trip.
So today we are about to hop a train to make our way over to Edinburgh, which is just east of here. Should be a nice short train ride, and we're really looking forward to seeing that city.
We rode the train into the city center, unable to see much of Edinburgh out the windows.
So when we exited the station and looked around, we found ourselves suddenly in the middle of a storybook.
We made it.
The majesty of the Scottish capital took our breath away.
Hostel is not only right here with a beautiful view of the Edinburgh Castle, but there's a beer garden run by the hostel right outside. How's it going?
This is so nice.
It's our best hostel yet, huh?
Yeah, so far.
It's so cool. We're just blasting Lana Del Rey in here. Since we got here in Edinburgh, we checked in and we've been walking around to a bunch of different shops. All very fun, like cool aesthetics, things that like we can't imagine really buying or needing, but a lot of fun to walk around.
This episode goes out to my brother, Jerry. My brother is a big Monsters fan, and specifically Frankenstein. So we're at Frankenstein's pub, and it's in an old church. They've got old Frankenstein like movies playing. The theming is fantastic. So Jerry, this one's for you. After a day full of exploration, music, food, and drinks, we headed back to our hostel as the sun set on Edinburgh Castle.
Amazing. Back in our hostel, and it's trivia night.
You were all correct. Well done.
Wow. It's gonna be hard to leave these kinds of breakfasts.
I'm just saying we're getting so used to this, this should just be like a standard back home. It won't be.
And we get to try vegan haggis for the first time. We are about to climb this.
I'm ready.
I think I'm ready too. We had a good breakfast, so I think we're prepared.
Yeah.
Arthur's Seat is an ancient volcano that was the mythological location of King Arthur's Camelot. From its peak, you can see the whole city of Edinburgh and the surrounding shores of the North Sea.
Rocky outcroppings, historical ruins, beautiful plants, and adorable dogs. The view from the top was stunning and most definitely worth all the work.
Back on solid ground. Grab a pint at the World's End.
While we were at the pub, Kaylee received a message from her cousin. She had a relative who owned a kilt shop in Edinburgh. We searched out the shop and found that it was only steps away.
We walked into the shop and the first person to greet us was the owner and my relative, William. I introduced myself and he walked us over to a counter and pulled out the Book of Leslie's. Inside were signatures of family members going back decades. He laid the book out and gave me a pen to sign it.
I didn't think I was going to find family here and then learn all of the history and then sign the Book of Leslie's. Wow.
That makes me emotional and I was just watching it happen.
He gave me like all of our history and he brought out a picture of a family member who actually renovated Leslie Castle. Yeah, I'm elated.
It's hard to describe my overwhelming feeling of connection to the past. This was an experience I would never forget. After seeing the Edinburgh Castle perched above us on Castle Rock for the last 2 days, it was finally time to explore it. So we wound our way up streets and narrow alleyways until we found the entrance.
Thank you.
castle was a hodgepodge of different eras. St. Margaret's Chapel was built around 1130, the Portcullis Gate in the 1500s, the Governor's House in 1742, and the new barracks in the early 1800s. Each structure helped to paint a picture of the ever-evolving role that the castle played throughout Scottish history.
Our favorite parts of the tour were seeing the Scottish crown jewels, which we weren't allowed to film, and the medieval Great Hall with its red ceilings and wooden rafters carved with animals.
Last night in Edinburgh. Charles Darwin stayed here once. Pretty neat. Alright, all vegetarian food. What? Look at this. Are you ready for this?
No.
I am. We have to review all of this that's happening right here because this might be like the best soul food meal, vegan, that I ever had.
Oh, hands down, this is the best.
These corn ribs. So you eat them like ribs where you eat the corn off of the rind. Potato salad, fantastic. Garlicky, I would say.
But pretty onions. Mild, it's not like too like mustardy or something.
Pickles, I hate pickles. These are pretty good though. You like them?
I love these.
Coleslaw is pretty mild, not very tangy. Okay, but the stars here are the barbecue sauce. Fantastic. This is a seitan steak, which is a consistency I've never had before. It's fantastic. It's the closest to steak that I've ever had. This like fried chicken seitan, which is a totally different consistency than the steak. And the breading is crispy and like there's a lot of different skills here coming together.
This is the closest you'll get to like a genuine like barbecue platter, but it's all vegan. I mean, it's, I don't think we're ever gonna find anything that tops this. Like this has to be it.
It's time we say goodnight to Edinburgh, our favorite city so far.
It's been amazing.
We had such a great time. So much good food.
Yeah.
Lost lineages and amazing views and amazing architecture. A truly beautiful place.
Yep.
And Kaylee's in tears.
Leaving Edinburgh. The first coffee.
We boarded a train bound for England and watched as Edinburgh's beautiful scenery passed by our windows one last time.